Dizzy. J. Hanna Dean, Dizzy. He was one of the most talented and colorful pitchers in Cardinal history, and outspoken. Dizzy was a leader in the famous Gas House Gang.
We are Mudgens, we're tough and wild men.
He was never shy. He used to say, "It ain't bragging if you can back it up." He also didn't mind talking about how much he was worth.
No, I haven't signed my contract this year yet, and don't expect to unless the Cardinals pay me $50,000. I'm worth $400,000 to the ball club. I'm at least worth $50,000 to myself.
For a few years, Dizzy was the most dominant pitcher in the game. In 1934, Dizzy's brother Paul, they called him Daffy, was part of the Cardinal pitching staff.
Well, Paul, we ought to win 45 ball games this year.
I think we will, Diz. If you'll win 35, I'll take care of the rest.
Nice going, boy.
Actually, they did better than that. Dizzy won 30 games, Paul won 19. In the 1934 World Series, Dizzy was sent in as a pinch runner and got hit in the head with a throw at second base and had to be carried off the field.
They carried me to the hospital, you know, took x-rays of my head and kept me in the hospital overnight. And the big headlines come over the next morning. X-rays of Dean's head shows nothing.
Dizzy pitched the Cardinals to an 11-0 victory over Detroit to win the 34 World Series. Sadly, Dizzy's career was shortened by a broken toe. We stopped Casey Stengel's story long enough at an old-timers game here in St. Louis for Diz to tell the story.
I saw him start out in baseball, and I think Miller Huggins was running the team here, and I believe it was Robinson Field or something like that. Was in the ballpark, and I was a young kid starting myself, and I saw this man get up, and I saw him get three or four hits. And when he got the three or four hits at the end of the year, they said, "Well, he's all right, but tell you the truth, he's playing shortstop. I tell you what he needs. He ought to be farmed out." Now then, in this day, nobody knew anybody could farm anybody out until the St. Louis Cardinals started, see? And then they farmed everybody in the world, so there was nothing on the farm but these boys from the farm. So he thought they meant being farmed out meant to go out and get some experience, so he did. He went down and worked on a farm. So he was the first fellow they ever farmed out with the Cardinals, became the greatest hitter in the world. Nobody taught him how to hit.
And I started the ball game in the third inning. We only allowed to pitch three innings in those days. And in the third inning, I had two men out, and Earl Averill came to the plate. And he had a line drive back and hit me on a big toe and broke it. We got him out on the play, but then 10 days later, I tried to pitch with a splint on my toe in Boston, Massachusetts against the Braves, and that's when I hurt my arm. And funny thing, Ron, I was 13 wins and one loss at the time that happened in 1937. I never won another ball game the rest of the year.
You were hard-headed enough to want to pitch.
I wanted to play ball. I believe that everybody wants to go out there and give them their best, and I believe they do, and I just love to play baseball. You know, when I signed my baseball contract, it was a lot better to go out there and pitch for $3,000 a year, and $7,500 is the most I got for winning 30 ball games, but it still beat picking cotton for 50 cents in Arkansas, I'll tell you that right now, partner.
Dizzy was honored by Babe Ruth for his pitching ability.
Dizzy Dean, they tell me that you're Dizzy, but if I could throw a ball like you, I'd like to be as dizzy as you are.
Thank you.
This is for your All-American.
Thank you.
Pleasure to pick you on the team.
Thank you.
After his playing career, Dean went into the broadcast booth and entertained fans in St. Louis on Cardinals and Browns games, and worked with Buddy Blattner on nationally televised games. He was often criticized for his folksy language by English teachers. He said, "A lot of folks who ain't saying ain't eating. So teach, learn them English, and I'll learn them baseball." He was inducted into the Baseball Hall of Fame in 1953, and now into the St. Louis Sports Hall of Fame.